In the waters of baptism, Sister Duane died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Sister Duane lived and affirmed her baptism through her Benedictine profession, in which she served the people of God in quiet dignity. May she join the long procession of the saints because of her faithfulness and love. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the soul of your servant, Sister Duane, who for love of Christ walked the way of perfect charity, may rejoice in the coming of your glory, and together with her sisters, may delight in the everlasting happiness of your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them. A time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time of war, and a time of peace. I have considered the task which God has appointed for people to be busy about. God has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into their hearts, without them ever discovering, from beginning to end, the work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by the power of God are safeguarded through faith to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now for a little while you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where am I going? You know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The monastic community would like to offer our sympathy and prayers to the family and friends of Sister Duane. We had the privilege of journeying with Sister Duane because she touched the lives of so many people. A heartfelt thank you to our healthcare staff who cared for Sister Duane with an unconditional love. With dignity and grace, she lived her monastic life, fulfilling her baptismal call by letting go to take the hand of God. In the gospel, Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Sister Duane would embrace those words, knowing someday Jesus would prepare a place for her. As in the gospel, Sister Duane did believe and allowed the works of Jesus, knowing life would not always be easy. Yet the gospel message was the fabric of her life when Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me." I became acquainted with Sister Duane back when I was in the eighth grade at St. Bernard School. With this personal history, Sister Duane did ask that I give the reflection. She was my religion teacher and math teacher, and often she would say, "I can see you sitting in the second row in the fourth seat." She was even brave enough to admit I was a quiet student. However, I have to be honest here. She gave me a D, not a B, a D in religion. Yep, a D. And I would remind her how this former student not only received a degree in theology, but I joined a religious community, and not just any religious community, a Benedictine community, and not just any Benedictine community, but the same one as hers. And I got a D in religion. We would laugh about that numerous times. She was a gentle teacher, and as I reflect, she not only taught me about my faith, but she taught me how to be an inquisitive student. When I joined this community, she tucked me under her wing, knowing a former student was now a member of that same community she often talked about when I was a student. She continued to be a teacher, and she believed in me, and I am grateful for the lessons she offered. Born in New Trier, Minnesota, to John and Margaret Moes, Sister Duane said her parents were the foundation of her vocation. She described her mother as a loving woman who would support her children no matter what the circumstances were. Her father was a strong-willed man. Since she was the only girl, she remembered playing with her brother's toys more than her own. Sister Duane spent her childhood in a rural community as part of a happy family. Her early years were lived in an atmosphere where her faith was nurtured, and she learned to seek a relationship with God and others rather than through possessions and prestige. These roots were important ones for her, not only because of the surroundings in which she grew up, but also because of the affection she developed for her family, an affection she treasured all her life. Both her parents were so proud the day she entered religious life. Her family was her strength, and each visit from the family was a tender memory for her. She had a special love for her many nieces and nephews, and especially those who served in the military. And Jeannie's face was a familiar one for the many visits. Sister Duane loved life and lived it fully in so many ways. She had a sharp and curious mind and a great sense of humor, and an appetite for good conversation when sharing about her family, relatives, and her monastic community. She had a love for Eucharist, the Liturgy of the Hours, and a dedication to the Blessed Mother. Her faith in God remained absolute. In the former monastery, there was no surprise to see a light on in her office late at night. She was our night security as she made the rounds, making sure all the doors and windows were locked. She was known for her giggle with squinted eyes during her storytelling. Often she talked about the parishes she so loved. She respected confidentiality, so she didn't say much about her term as prioress. She did say, as difficult as the role might have been, she enjoyed every moment. She loved each prioress in this community for their work. She said, no one knows what the prioress's job is unless you're in it. So there was a deep respect and prayer for those who followed her. She was humbled being one of the 178 founding charter members to make the journey from St. Benedict's in St. Joseph, Minnesota to 301 Summit in 1948. St. Paul's Monastery gives credit to those 178 brave sisters. And now, Sister Duane is the last of our charter members to die, as they are now united through eternal life. Sister Duane loved anything and everything that involved St. Benedict, whether it was a statue, a cross, the rule, or a medal. She could explain that Benedictine medal in both English and Latin, and she had knowledge about wisdom when it came to St. Benedict. The only thing she didn't know was how our Holy Father Benedict, whether he wrote the rule with his right hand or his left hand, that she did not know. But hopefully she'll know that now. And she died with a Benedictine medal beside her, which is exactly what she would have wanted. Sister Duane valued education by her pioneering spirit. She blessed moms, ministry of mothers sharing. She served as a counselor for the Federation of St. Benedict. And she was one of our founders of Maple Tree Child Care Center when the community decided to turn the former laundry building into a child care center here on campus, which continues to thrive today. Sister Duane was not shy about giving her opinion when asked, and sometimes she may have struggled with change. However, she was able to accept the new ideas which emerged from the change. She was elated to have time with her classmate, Sister Gergen. She could speak German, and nothing got in the way of bingo when she was in the healthcare. During one of my last visits with Sister Duane, she reminded me to continue to share prayer with those who were ill. And one needs to always be grateful for the gift of life. She invited those around her to grow and see the value of diversity of personalities. These past years, she may have been confused about the present, but she knew her past. She shared with me how she silently prayed, Jesus, take this away from me. I belong to you, not to this pain. She mentioned how she tried her best to love all. With Sister Duane's declined sight, she truly was a witness to the scripture verse in 2 Corinthians, we walk by faith, not by sight. And her favorite song was 139, the all-knowing and ever-present God. And she especially memorized verse 5. You go before me and follow me. You place your hand of blessing on my head. And God placed his hand of blessing on her head during her final days. Sister Duane lives in all of us, in our memories, in our hearts, and in our spirits. Her light was so bright, it's hard to imagine the world without it. Her pain is gone, her soul is free, and her absence is a reminder of her personal triumph. The Lord opened a door and said, come, I have a new body for you. The old one is finished. Sister Duane has gone through that door to a new life. For us, it is over in a physical sense, but for her, this is just the beginning of new life as she reunites with her parents and brothers. Thank you, Sister Duane, for the music that lifts our hearts in one breath to heaven, for the grasp of friendship, and for the gracious loveliness of your vocation, but mostly for the beauty and joy you have brought to those in need. You served us well, good and faithful servant. We thank God for your journey and for your monastic vocation, so that in all things, God may be glorified.
Sisters, in sorrow and grief, but also in faith and hope, we make our prayers known to God, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in God's ways. Our response will be, hear our prayer.
We pray for Sister Duane, who in baptism received the light of Christ, was nourished at the table of the Savior, and as a faithful sister, spent her life following Jesus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all who mourn the death of Sister Duane, especially those who are unable to be present today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for women who are being called by God to live the Benedictine way of life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all of us that, like Sister Duane, we may see and love God in all of our brothers and sisters. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who suffer from injustice and violence, especially brothers and sisters in our own country. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all the deceased members of our Federation, especially our own Sister Helene, who died on this day in the year 2000, Sister Mary Jane Slaney from St. Benedict's Monastery, and Sister Thomas Weldon from Annunciation Monastery. May they rest in God's loving presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hear our prayers, loving God, as we commend our Sister Duane transform our grief into hope. Fill the void we fill with your love. Comfort us with your promise of resurrection. We make our prayers in the name of your Son, Jesus, our risen Lord and Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
My Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
In the love of Christ, let us acknowledge one another with a smile or a word of peace. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. God, your Son, Jesus Christ, gave us the sacrament of his body and blood to guide us on our pilgrim way to your kingdom. May our Sister Duane, who shared in the Eucharist, come to the banquet of life that Christ has prepared for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Sister Duane. And now we have come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we will see Sister Duane again and enjoy her friendship. Although this community dispersed in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of the kingdom. Let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Which is our safety in time of uncertainty and fear, and our light and our peace always. Gift us with the spirit of Saints Scholastica and Benedict, and the faith of all those women who have gone before us, that we may run the way of God's commandments with unspeakable sweetness of love. We ask this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.